rings.
Shine a ring.
All right, I want everyone to please stand up. All right, hands over your hearts. All right, and let us all say the pledge on a count of two. One, two. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we'd watch, were so gallantly streaming, and the
to our 59th commencement ceremony at Wilbur Cross High School at this location. I'd like to welcome Honorable Mayor Justin Ellicker, our two assistant superintendents, Dr. Paul White, Evie Velasquez, all of our friends and family, my awesome staff and teachers, and the most important people that are here today, the class of 2021. First, I would like to acknowledge all of our students, and our students are graduates, because you're no longer my students anymore, but our graduates who will be going to the armed forces. Can you please stand up? I don't know, some of you are in the 2 o'clock run. Thank you, let's go. So we are so proud of you. Thank you for your service. Thank you for being brave and going into the armed forces, and we honor you and what you do going forth. Next, I'd like to have a moment of silence and honor all of the loved ones that we as our Cross community have lost this year. Thank you. Our students and our staff, we have lost mothers, fathers, siblings, parents, cousins, aunts, uncles, and family, friends, and important people in our lives at an alarming rate this year. I send all of you who have experienced loss and grief my love, my prayers, and I hope to help you through your grief. However, I do genuinely believe in my heart that every person that we lost this year is looking down on us on this glorious, beautiful day, and they're so proud of you, and they love you, and their spirit is surrounding us and protecting us. So I just wanted to take a moment to honor that and remember those loved ones who should be here with us. I've thought a lot about what I was going to say to you, and those of you who know me know I always have something to say, but I realize this is the last time that you're going to be forced to sit here and listen to me. That's supposed to be funny. They laughed when I practiced it. Okay, no, you guys haven't seen me in a year. You forgot that I'm really funny? Okay, so I was really at a loss of what I was going to tell you, because what can I really say in this unprecedented time? How do I inspire you when you leave here after we've had such a challenging year? We've experienced a lot of loss, some more than others, a lot of times in talking to many of you and your teachers and your parents, loss more than we can bear for lots of different things. However, what we need to be proud of is that we persevered through this and we are here today. We're here to celebrate your accomplishments. This is just one step on the many wonderful accomplishments and journeys you will have throughout your life. In August 2017, when you were all about this high and ninth graders and scared, and you walked into the building and the auditorium, I told you that you were destined for greatness. I told you that I had very high expectations for you. And I challenged everyone that in 4 years to walk across this stage. And I remember saying 4 years is going to go by very quickly. And it did. During that time, I never imagined that we would be experiencing a global pandemic. I never thought that we would be out of school for a year. And we would miss so much. But think about all the things that you have learned during this last year and a half, in the last 4 years. We've learned how to persevere. We've learned how to be patient. We learned that having your face in your phones and on the computer all day is not healthy. But most importantly, we learned about the human connection and how important it is to be with each other, to fellowship with each other, to talk to each other. I want you to remember that. I believe that your generation will be instrumental in building a better future and a better society. I hope that your time out of school and as you continue to grow into wonderful, beautiful adults, that you continue to read, you learn more about the world, about racial injustice, about how to contribute, how to be a contributing member to society, and it's your responsibility to make it a better place. If you remember anything that I say to you, because I know most of you are not going to remember anything that I tell you today, but if you remember anything, remember, you always have choices. I said this to you in 2017 and probably almost every class meeting we had since then. While you may not like all of your choices, you have them. It is important to be critical thinkers, to be strategic in the choices you make, as the choices you make can and will impact the rest of your life. Lastly, I just want to share a couple of things. I whittled my list down of things that I've learned in my 43 years on this earth, and I hope you listen and take this advice. Be proud of the skin that you are in. Never let anyone make you feel less than. If someone does, walk away, because you always deserve better. Fall hard and fall in love with yourself. Never lie to yourself. Reserve "I am sorry" and "forgive me" for when you really mean it. Travel light through life. Keep only what you need. Find your tribe and love them hard, because true friends are hard to find. And as you go travel through this world, you will learn that lesson. It's okay to cry when you are hurt. It's okay to smash things. But wash your face, clean your mess, and get up off the floor when you're done, because you don't belong down there. Just because you can doesn't mean that you should. Very important lesson. Remember that one. Happiness is not a permanent state. Wholeness is. Don't confuse the two. Can't is a cop-out. Hold your heroes in high standard, but make sure you're your own hero. If you have an opinion, you better know why. Practice your passion. Ask for what you want. The worst thing that they can tell you is no. Say what you mean and mean what you say. Lastly, be sure to lead with kindness and love. No matter where you are on this planet, you can always come back home to Cross for support, We will be here. We love you. We are proud of you. You are awesome, fabulous, great, and you are forever and will forever be my beautiful governors. Thank you. Next, we will have a few words from Mayor Elliker.
Good morning. Is this a graduation? Can we hear some noise out there? Is this a graduation? Congratulations to you all and your families for getting you across the finish line in one of the most challenging years our city has ever experienced. And I want to take a moment in particular to thank Principal Johnson and your team. I remember it was, I don't know, maybe 8 months ago, the pandemic was, we were seeing cases increase significantly, and we were doing a tour of Cross. Nobody was there because the school was shut down, and we were talking about all the logistics of how to get young people back into schools. And I remember being in the band room, and we were talking about all these different things that the principal and your team had thought through to just get band practice going, instruments to go on top of the instruments to keep the noise in, and the drums. We're doing singing. The plan was to do singing outside some in the wintertime if it's nice out, or maybe in the gym. And then someone brought up, well, what are you going to do about the flutes? And we all looked at each other and had no idea what to do about the flutes. And I think that's just one example of so many challenging decisions that we have all made over this past year, from the small details around how are we going to manage band practice to the very, very significant support and choices that we've had to make to support each other and ensure that everyone has the resources that they need when they lose a family member, when teachers are concerned about coming into the classroom because of the HVAC system, when family members have potentially lost a job. And all of those challenges are something that you, your teachers, your paraprofessionals, administrators, and your families have been able to overcome in this year. I've been talking at a number of graduations about a phrase that's in Chinese, an expression. It's goji tiao qiang. And what it means is when a dog is backed up against the wall because they're cornered, the dog is able to jump over a really tall wall that you never expected the dog to jump over. And it's a really kind of weird way of saying when you're facing the most challenging time in life, when you feel like there's so much pressure on you and there may be no way out of your situation, that is the moment when you are most powerful. Then you are when you are most able to accomplish things that you never imagined you could accomplish, when you're most able to jump over that wall. And when you think about this past year, it's an example of what we've been able to accomplish together. And I hope you take that example forward, because you all are going to face incredible challenges in your life. And you may not even know when they're going to arise. But you have shown this year, thanks to the support of your family and your network, and most importantly, your confidence, your courage, that you can overcome those challenges. So I wish you luck as you move forward in the next phase of your life. And as mayor, I'm not supposed to have favorites, so I was really nervous about whether I should put this on because I'm going to Hill House later this afternoon. But I'm doing it. I'm doing it, everybody. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Next, we will have, next, we will have a song by Annalise Vasquez, Hero. Annalise, where are you? Come on, girl.
Thank you.
not to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. The strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you. It's a long road when you face the world alone. No one reaches out a hand for you to hold. You can find love if you search within yourself, and that emptiness you felt will disappear. And you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you. Oh, 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 I know. Dreams are hard to follow, but don't let anyone tear them away. Oh, no. There will be tomorrow. In time, you'll find the way. And then a hero comes along with the strength carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.
I wish I could sing like that. All right, and next in our program, we will have our salutatorian, Miss Lily Walton. Woohoo! Yeah, Lily!
Good morning, fellow students, parents, grandparents, families, teachers, staff, and guests. Welcome to the Wilbur Cross graduation ceremony for the class of 2021. I'm Lily Walton, and it's with great honor that I stand before you today as this year's salutatorian. First, I want to give a special thank you to our teachers for guiding us, our guidance counselors for advising us, and our parents and guardians for supporting us. I feel like graduation caught me by surprise. Maybe some of you feel the same way. It seems like only yesterday that we walked into the atrium for the first time as scared freshmen, hardly knowing where we were going, having no clue what the A wing is or where the V wing is. I can now say with pride that after 4 years here, I don't get lost anymore. This school has many wings. There's A and there's B and V and E. And for every wing, there are a million different experiences and paths through this school. None of us have taken the same path through these hallways, and after Wilbur Cross, none of us will take the same path forward. Nonetheless, within these walls, we have all been able to find the communities where we belong, to create friendships that we cherish, and to discover the people we are or want to become. We have had models of empathy all around us. The teachers who are generous with their time to be the faculty advisor for a student club, the teachers who are eager to talk during Wellness Wednesday office hours, the main office staff who collected textbooks through the outside windows in June of 2020, the main Mr. Flanagan, who always returns my calls, Mrs. Johnson, who is always in the hallways talking to students. Wilbur Cross is a compassionate community. Let me tell you a story about that. It was junior year, and my English teacher, Mrs. Nelkin, had just given us a big assignment. We each had to write a speech. The topic was up to us. We just had to get up in front of the class and talk. I found this assignment a little scary. It's hard to be vulnerable about your passions, right? When the day of the speeches finally arrived, I was nervous. Public speaking scared me. It still does, even today. And I just wanted to get it over with. But as soon as the first speaker got up to stand in front of our half circle of desks, I was struck speechless by my classmates' passion and dedication to their chosen causes. Some speeches were pleas for political reform. Some were demands for better policy about climate change. One was a fed-up declaration of feminism. Every single one was unique. Each of us had managed to steep our words in our own perspectives, showing and sharing the communities we come from and our classmates listening with compassion. It took a lot of guts to stand up there and talk, for some more than others. But it just proved to me what can happen when we share what we care about. We can create entire new communities. Our English class was really close after that, a new and unexpected community for all of us, way down in the V-wing. Not everybody has had this experience of a bonded class, but each of us may have found that community elsewhere in our Wilbur Cross lives. Whether that community looks like a tight-knit huddle in the locker room, waiting for the game to start, or the blinding glare of the stage lights during a school production, or whispered conversations with friends in the library, we all have our people, the people we want to take care of. As this pandemic has shown us, our communities are our lifeblood, and empathy is our sustenance. And I know that this class of 2021 will carry that knowledge forward with us in the world outside of Wilbur Cross, beyond the A or the E wing. Despite our interrupted junior year and our mostly remote senior year, we've managed to maintain our attachments through just about anything, even after our 13 months in quarantine away from Cross. That's not to say that we won't look for new experiences or stray from our comfort zones in the future. In fact, our class has had to be extremely flexible. We faced a lot of challenges that seemed impossible, both as a class and as individuals, and we've stretched and grown in ways that we couldn't have imagined. From those days when Cross lost internet for a few hours and Google Classroom crashed, to forgetting what people look like in person, to taking AP tests online, to taking care of siblings at home during class, our class of 2021 has been tested. But whatever our communities look like going forward, whether that's a sports team, a military squad, a book club, a band, or an activist group, we now have the skills to make a place for ourselves in our new setting. to create and find new communities by sharing our passions and individuality, and to push through any challenges we face with empathy and strength. As the poet Mary Oliver said in her poem, Breakage, it's like a schoolhouse of little words, thousands of words. First, you figure out what each one means by itself, the jingle, the periwinkle, the scallop, full of moonlight. Then you begin slowly to read the whole story. We've all contributed to our story here at Wilbur Cross, and now it's time for each of us to take what we've learned and start figuring out the next chapter on our own. I know we will all find our way. Congratulations, class of 2021.
And next, we will have our valedictorian, Alexandra Northrup, AKA Sasha.
Hi everyone, sorry I'm a bit nervous, just bear with me. Okay, so I know the other speeches have done this before, but I'm gonna have you all just stand up and start cheering. Get up, cheer, come on, yes, get up, cheer, yes, 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 okay, yes, all right. Class of 2021, we have finally graduated, oh my God, yes. Let's hear it for our loved ones, hi mom. Let's hear it for our teachers. But most of all, let's hear it for us, come on, yes, yes. Yay, okay, that worked. All right, sit down. Sit down. All right. Thank you for participating. That was fun. It actually worked. Okay. So my hands are numb. Okay. So now I'm going to speak in front of a bunch of people who don't know me. Great. Hi, my name is Sasha, and I want to talk about something that is very important to me and something that I believe is a tough topic for many people, self-worth. And yes, I did make all of you stand up and cheer just for me to start getting all serious, so stand up and cheer if you have self-worth. No, no one's standing up, see? Exactly. But no, seriously, it's something that we all need to work on. We all need to work on self-worth. Yes, okay. But the reason I'm saying this is because for most of my life, I have not felt worthy of being alive. I will just admit something. My own ambition or drive or passion is not the reason that I am the valedictorian of this graduating class. Depression runs in my family, so I've had some run-ins with that. I easily develop nervous tics. I have anxiety, and I have trouble finding pleasure in my daily life. I was even having serious trouble writing this speech because I wasn't taking ownership of my own success. I did not feel worthy of the title valedictorian. To be honest, I'm still having trouble with feeling worthy of my position. But this, just like most things in my life, is another thing for me to work on. And I like to think that I have gotten better. I believe that the reason I'm the valedictorian of this graduating class is because I finally realized that I am worthy of being alive. Thank you. Thank you. So, excuse me. I want to tell you a bit how I discovered my own self-worth. So the first part of discovering my own self-worth was realizing that I didn't know my own self-worth. All I will say is that having mercy on yourself is allowing yourself to heal from whatever has hurt you. It's a common misconception that going through tough times is what makes you strong and builds character. That is a flat-out lie. Tough times is what breaks you. Healing is what makes you strong. So please have mercy on yourself and start to heal. Now, the second part of discovering my own self-worth was realizing that I was terrified of the world around me. To really give you an idea, whenever I would find myself going the wrong direction between classes, I just kept on walking in the same wrong direction no matter what, even if I might be late to class, or, and this often happened to me as a freshman, even if I got more lost, nope, just keep walking. I was like Dory from Finding Nemo, but with none of her confidence. Why? Apparently, I had decided that simply doubling back in a hallway was social suicide. I thought that everyone would just stare at me, you know, look at that idiot going in the wrong direction. But what was I thinking? Thankfully, this fear of mine did change, so thank you to Chef Bradshaw, Jamie, Tashi, Jen, and Sochi of the Culinary Department's management team for teaching me to have confidence in parts of the world that I haven't explored yet. I love you guys. I mean, it really is amazing what the knowledge of running a restaurant can do to your walking posture, you know, like target demographics, oops, going the wrong way, menu advertising, whatever. And thank you to Mr. McKinney, Margot, Emily, and Brandon of the National Honor Society leadership team for teaching me that the parts of the world that I haven't explored yet are already confidently waiting for me. You know, the first word that came to my mind when the National Honor Society elections were being held was no. But someone had already spread a rumor that I was running for president, don't know why, and I figured, why not? And here I am. Seriously, you never know what you may encounter when you stop fearing the world. I really encourage you, don't let the world scare you. The third part of discovering my own self-worth was realizing that I was not using my voice. Many people who know me know that I am pretty darn shy, and I know that the shyness of mine stems from the fact that I was ashamed of and guilty about myself. I am not now. So, thank you. Now I want to thank Ms. Nelkin and her AP Lang class, as well as the Feminist Literature Club, hi, for giving me a space to use my voice. I will never forget that during one of our class circles, the quietest girl in AP Lang, a girl who I considered shyer than even myself, and that is saying something, she called me shy. And for some reason, I was absolutely shocked and offended. No, I'm just, you know, quiet and reserved. No, I'm just shy. Then this girl proceeded to remark on how I had come out of my shell during the course of AP Lang, and she was not wrong. For someone who immediately gets dizzy, chokes on their own words, loses their breath, and turns as red as a tomato during basic conversations, for someone like me to learn and to write and give a speech for an AP Lang midterm, that takes a miracle, and AP Lang truly was a miracle. I learned how to use my voice, and I'm proud that now I'm still using my voice, and I encourage you to start using your voice. The fourth part of discovering my own self-worth was realizing that I was living a passionless life. Like I said, I have trouble finding pleasure in my daily life, and I am working on that. But this first changed when I started taking Italian at Cross. So now I want to thank Ms. Farfone, literally the one, the only Italian teacher. Thank you for teaching me la bella lingua. Even though I switched into Italian 1 2 weeks after the class started, and even though my phone got stolen as soon as I switched into that class, joke's on you, thief. You may have outsmarted my utterly oblivious 14-year-old self, but I just got a new phone. After a really shameful trip to the Apple store. Getting a new phone is supposed to be exciting, but it's not exciting when all you can think about is what if the thief goes through your texts and discovers that, you know, your sense of humor is basically just Facebook cat memes. It's one thing to be robbed, but another thing to be exposed. Anyways, really, despite my very rocky start with the language, learning Italian was one of my favorite things about high school. Instead of finding no point in my existence as a high school student, I would find myself practicing newly learned Italian conjunctions. Really, it meant so much to me, Ms. Farfone, that after seeing how much I loved your class, you were willing to break a professional rule and teach me in an independent study when I couldn't fit your class into my schedule. I found myself getting excited about something, which was pretty rare for me. Thereafter, le cose sono solo migliorate. Things only got better. And I encourage you to find something that you are passionate about. The fifth part of discovering my own self-worth was realizing that other people believed in me. So now I want to thank Ms. Bartone, officially the world's best guidance counselor. She isn't at Cross anymore, but yeah, I know she's on the live stream, so hi to New Jersey. Honestly, I don't think that I would be standing here on this stage giving this speech if not for having Ms. Bartone as my guidance counselor. Anytime that I came into her office, she was ready for me, and that is remarkable considering one of the first major interactions I had with her. As a freshman, I foolishly decided to be brave and try out for the school musical. Oh, the masochist I was. And Miss Bartone was at my audition as one of the judges. I decided to sing Defying Gravity, only I forgot half of the song as soon as I got on stage, and it was a miracle that the ceiling didn't defy physics and crush me. And this was all in front of my guidance counselor. But Miss Bartone did not let my reproachful rendition of Defying Gravity stop her from defying practically impossible scheduling conflicts, teacher disputes, and really anything that got in my way. I am so glad that I managed to see that she believed in my academic ability, because even having just a couple of people in your corner can change your entire life. And I encourage you to believe that others believe in you. They really do. And lastly, the sixth part of discovering my own self-worth was realizing that I wasn't taking ownership of my life. So I want to thank my mother for this realization, among many lessons that my mother has taught me, such as don't make any important final decisions when you're tired, crying, and about to go to bed, and don't trust realtors, and be aware of your environment. You were right, Mom. The real reason I broke my glasses was because I did sit on them and then drop them and then clean them a bit too hard. Anyways, among all the lessons that you have taught me, the most impactful one has been to take ownership of my life. Not only have you always been there for me in my overwhelming academic life, but you have also always been there for me to check and, you know, just ask if I was happy and point out my overwhelming apathy and make me question what I used to accept as a depressing reality. So thank you for teaching me that I am worthy of living. Thank you, Mom. I love you. So I just want to say thank you to everyone who has helped me realize that I shouldn't be afraid of the world around me, that I ought to use my voice, that I need to have passions, that people truly support me, that I need to own my life, that I am worthy of being alive. Thank you to everyone who has helped me with this. And before I sit back down in my fancy folding chair, I want to say this. You are worthy of being alive, and once you realize that, nothing can stop you. Thank you for listening to me.
Thank you, Sasha. Was that not amazing? Thank you for being vulnerable. Thank you for sharing your story. Thank you. So next, we will have our keynote speaker, William Billy Johnson, who is Wilbercross class of 1994. Mr. Johnson, soon to be Dr. Johnson, what in a couple of weeks, is the director of the educational strategy at the William Caspar Groundstein Memorial Fund. He is certified by the state of Connecticut to be a school superintendent. Mr. Johnson has also worked as an assistant superintendent, director of instruction, principal, and teacher. As a consultant, he has worked on strategic plans with the district, with districts, organizations, and communities. He has two master's degrees in educational leadership from Southern Connecticut State and special education from the University of Connecticut. He is also a doctoral student in the Global Executive Doctorate of Education program at the University of Southern California, an adjunct professor in educational leadership, a board member of the Citywide Youth Coalition New Haven, and a Deeper Learning Equity Fellow, and also my personal friend, and I had to give him a huge shout out because he always represents Cross, always shows Cross love. So please give it up for our keynote speaker and Wilbur Cross graduate, Governor, Mr. Billy Johnson.
Yeah, so I hear you, Red. First, I want to just say, I don't remember the entire kind of graduation, but what you will remember is how your loved ones feel when you go to them after this. I thought about who spoke to me, and it must have been really whack because I don't remember, right? What I decided to do was I said, you know, it would probably be valuable to you if an older person, because I am not old, just older than you, share some lessons that actually I wish I could tell my 18-year-old self this day. So 2020 and 2021 has been just
a year in my life that I'll never forget, and you probably won't either. But I want to tell you, it's not an anomaly in the historical context of our country. And that's actually a sad fact. So a letter to my 18-year-old self. This letter is to me, my loved ones, and also to you and your loved ones. 18-year-old self, I want to tell you, winning awards was not enough. I want to tell you, graduating was not enough. I want to tell you, obtaining 4 college degrees was not enough. I want to tell you, getting a good job was not enough. I want to tell you, being a great parent, uncle, friend, partner, it's not enough. It is not that all these things are not admirable accomplishments, but none of them really matter if you are missing key life learnings that unfortunately we didn't learn in a classroom. Here's what I'll share with you, 18-year-old self. The education you received has just taught you how to participate in the current world. But I beg you, please educate yourself so you can help create a better world. The education you just received taught you old things. I beg you, please educate yourself on the complete history of our country and the complete history about yourself so you can create new history and new things. Are you listening, 18-year-old self? Take some notes on this part, because these are some mistakes. Learn about debt-to-income ratio. My first job as a teacher, I made $38,000, lived in my mother's one-room apartment in the hill where I grew up, and I bought a car that cost me $45,000. Do the math. This is true, so all real talk. Learn about credit. All of you have smartphones at this point. Start watching videos on debt-to-income ratio and credit. Learn about investing in yourself, in your dreams, and in your future. Learn about real estate. Learn about the legacy of capitalism because it will impact your ability to work and care for your family. Learn about the legacy of racism because it continues to divide us, although it's hundreds of years old. 18-year-old self, at this very moment, the current world has taught you there is not enough for all of us, and that you are competing with the person next to you. But together, if you learn those things above, you will know we live in a world rich with resources, and there's enough for us all. An 18-year-old self, with other young adults, you can create a new world with new ideas that is inclusive of all human beings. 18-year-old self, don't just make decisions for you. Make decisions for you, the future you, and all humanity around you. I wish you all peace and blessings. Congratulations, 2021.
I would be remiss, because I got so excited, I have to give a huge shout out to the Wilbur Cross Band, who can, hello? It's 10 o'clock, everybody should be up. Let's go, the Wilbur Cross Band. So before we get to the most important thing that we are here for, we are going to have a quick, beautiful musical selection from our band that is entitled To Reach the Summit. All right, Mr. Teichman and kids, take it away. Thank you. Band. So now, the main reason that we are here, first, I need to give a huge shout out to our superintendent, Dr. Eileen Tracy, who will share some words after we present the candidates. So, are you excited? Are you ready? This is the last time you're going to have to be captive with me. Okay, so we are going to begin to present the candidates. So, candidates, please stand. And let's get started. We're going to stand up and move. All right. Parents, just so you know, a professional picture is going to be taken of your children on the field. And then by tomorrow morning, you can go to the Wilbur Cross website. You will be able to download the picture for free. If you would like to have it touched up and printed, you will have to pay a fee. And that link is on the website. So, Ms. Brianza? Hey, you too.
I'm gonna wait for a couple more to line up. Yeah, Tasha, you're doing.
They gotta hurry up. They gotta hurry up and do it.
They gotta get the line going. All right, I present to you Tasha Lee Hernandez. Helen Guzman. Sasha Northrup. Lily Walton. Natalia, happy birthday, Greg! Lorelai Goodall! Layla Tracy! Emily Lathers. Yeah.
William Gilbert. Tishon Gardner. Gabriela Reyes. Armani McKnight. Serena Anez. Elena Selick. Edwin Bartolone. Edgar Guaman. Nicole Colon Martinez. Delilah Martinez. Annalise Vasquez. Janeta Castro. Kiara McLeese. Nairisha McCollum. Kimberly Ross. Nayelis Morero. Carolise Melendez. Tanisha Fisher. Joseph Estrada. Pedro Soto. Cameron Pastor Staten. Leasia Brody. Frank Gomez. Jose Cantania. Khalil Davis. Joseph Taylor Smith. Takai Johnson. John Perez. Henry Bravo. Jonathan Denisa. Brandon Crespo. Ian Leal Pintor. Mauricio A. Quintanilla. Jermaine Pugh. Julian Geraldo Barragan. Angelo Pena. Jareli Calderon Romero. Andrew Edwards. Arbriana Franklin. De'Asia Davis. Ewing Waffley. Miguel Torres. Luis Acosta. Jeremiah Sampson. Guanier Ford. David Messina. Elijah McCrory. Genizabeth Flores. Dior Hobson. Fredo Diaz. Kevin Cian Tercios. Santiago Solis. Wendy Grisel Reyes. William Barahona. Alexis Eduardo Cruz Alvarez. Marjorie Gomez. Sebastian Estrada. Jose Solano. Oscar Segui. Annette Salazar. Timothy Brunson. Paras Pandi. MD Hoke. Jesus Mejia Hernandez. Michael Gambrell. Aldo Fuentes. Geralice Melpica. Stephanie Pelcar Saraguro. LaShia Robinson. Joshua Lee Sampson. Christopher Rosa. Jairi Porti Ramos. Wisam Altamimi. Sayasin Somsan Sai. Daniel Trasianka. Milabinge Jacques. Jabez Cubis. Chad Wayne Harris. James Marshall. Pablo Giannotti Garlinghouse. Elmer Lucero. Cecilia Santos. Carlos Rodriguez. Kanai Colbreth. Anisha Torres. DeAndre Presley. Danny H. Parks. Sincere Lee Rosa. Tyler Mitchell. Alfie Diaz. Jundell Torres. Lucas Bosch. Lamoral Foster. Brian Segovia. Jen C. J. Estrada. Antonio J. Acosta. Nasir Cartier-Lloyd. Jali Guo. Princess Rohina. Ezekiel Maldonado. Armani Henderson. Robert Wells. Michael DeLeon. Ludier Calcano. Natalia Maria Padilla Castellanos. Mateo Balmarin. David Rodriguez. Joseph Choi. Gershon Ericker. Jacob Martin. Skyla Thomas. Cecilis Ocasio. Steven Mejia. Jason Alston. Michael Acosta. Edward Garza. Kiana Castings Berrios. Elizabeth Morales. Emmanuel Ramos. Caitlin De Lima. Bryant Cruz. Pedro Jimenez. Sochi Sanchez Guerrero. Alexandra Alexandra Miranda. Diana Melara. Ahmed Ali. Dylan Cruz. Saja Nawabi. Alex Espinosa. Jocelyn M. Rivera. Juliana D. Velez. Laisha Abad. Erica Rieva. Erika Sarango. George Keyless. Isaiah Housley. Gleishmari Roman.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is our graduating class. We just had a minor technical piece, so we just want to wait for the last few rows to take their picture. And then we will continue. So if we could just give us about 5 minutes so we can get that. If we could just put a little music on, please. If you guys want to sit down, just give me 1 minute. Next, while we are waiting for our graduates to finish taking their pictures, we're going to have a few words from our Honorable Superintendent, Dr. Eileen Tracy.
Good morning to everyone. Good morning to class of 2021. You made it. You made it. You should be so proud of yourselves. And may I say, more proud are your families and friends and well-wishers. They are so proud of you. Many years ago, when you were born, they were happy to cradle you in their hands. I know that as a mother. Now you're at the struggle with you throughout your how many years, whether 17 or 18, and here you are. Do not give up on your parents. No matter how old you think you are, they are still your parents. You can never be older than or smarter than they are. Honor and respect them no matter how far you reach in life. When I go and visit my mom, I melt into her hands like a little child again. But that's what it reminds me of. Your parents have been great to you. Your teachers have done an extraordinary job with you to get you this far. Honor your teachers. So without much further, I'm not going to steal your moment. I'm going to ask graduates, please stand. I want to face your families and give them a round of applause. Thank you so much. Turn around. Give your teachers and administrators a round of applause. And more so, give yourselves a large, huge round of applause. You may be seated. I did that because all of us have some part to play in this moment of your lives. Everyone had a part to play. And that shows us that through working together, collaborating, I'm shoring up your experiences. Some may have been positive along the journey, some may not, but here you are. You are resilient, you are persevering, and you're committed. If you do not leave this learning environment with anything else, leave with this. Go into the world with compassion and kindness. Of all the content knowledge that we have, if you leave this institution of learning without being compassionate and kind, you have not learned anything. So I'm imploring you, remember those who are hurting and suffering. Remember your path that you need to make for yourselves. And remember, you cannot do it alone. You need others to lean on. So reach out and touch somebody's hand and make this world a better place because you can. Thank you very much.
Everybody. Oh, we got a little Bruno Mars going. Yeah? I know you don't want to see me dance. I can dance, but if you want me to, I will. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're just going to have our graduates sit down. They will have an opportunity because we want to just kind of move forward through the ceremony, and they will have an opportunity to come back and take their picture in a few minutes. All right. Do you want to hear me sing? No? A little bit. Yeah. I can't. My boss is here. I can't get in trouble. You know, if it was just us in the school, you know. But my boss is here. I can't, you know, we can't. This is not coronation and, you know, our, you know, with coronation, you know, and it's coronation and prom and stuff is a little different. But we got, you know, my boss is here, so I have to act right today. Okay? So, ladies and gentlemen, parents, grandparents, friends, aunts, uncles, titis, tios, abuelos, everybody, let's congratulate and cheer for the class of 2021. Okay. So, I kind of want to cherish this moment because this is the last time I can hold you hostage, because when I'm done speaking, you guys can do whatever you want. I can't say too much anymore. Dr. White, Assistant Superintendent, and Dr. Tracy, Superintendent of New Haven Public Schools. Will the class of 2021 please stand? I present to you the most beautiful, the most intelligent, the most kind graduating class of Wilbur L. Cross High School.
Principal Johnson, do you certify that they have completed all the requirements set forth by the New Haven Board of Education and the State of Connecticut?
I do certify, sir.
Principal Johnson, it is my pleasure then to, on behalf of the New Haven Board of Education, do accept the Wilbur Course Class of 2021 and do confer upon them the high school diploma with all rank, privilege, and insignia. Congratulations.
So, thank you. So, graduates, you may turn your tassel. You are official, certified, Wilbur L. Cross High School graduates of the class of 2021. This does conclude our graduation ceremony, and I want to just say this before we recess out. Thank you. We had a bit of a technical difficulty in the back. Those graduates who did not have their professional picture taken, please just recess to line up to get your picture taken. And then the other graduates, you may recess out onto the field. Families, you can meet your children and your graduates on the side field over here to take pictures. And thank you so much for coming.
On behalf of the New Haven Board of Education, do accept the Wilbur Course Class of 2021 and do confer upon them the high school diploma with all rank, privilege, and insignia. Congratulations.
So, thank you. So, graduates, you may turn your tassel. You are official. Certified Wilbur L. Cross High School graduates of the class of 2021.